Hey everybody, tonight we got something a little bit different for you. Jordan's been out in the garage again doing his mad scientist thing, so I thought I'd show you what he came up with and see what you think of it. What do you got for us tonight, bud?
I guess we're calling it the tactical assault camera mount, and all it is I wanted something, well, we wanted something that we could use while we're filming drag racing to track the cars faster while they're going down the strip. And I looked up some things online and they had these like gun-shaped camera mounts that I thought were kind of interesting, but they all looked either a little flimsy or they wanted way too much money for them, so I made my own.
And what'd you make it all out of? Let's just kind of go through it here.
Well, if you remember, we have a 12-gauge that we like to shoot. There's videos of that if you want to check them out. But I put a collapsible stock on it a while back, and we had used it, and it wasn't working very good with that gun because it kicked so hard and it was smacking us in the face, so I ended up wanting to put the old one back on it, and I had this one sitting around. And I decided this would be perfect for it because, you know, it's adjustable and you can move it back and forth for different shoulder length and stuff, and arm length. And this is just some aluminum bar stock that we had laying around. I don't remember what we were using it for, but I put it in the vise and kind of angled it so it would go straight and be parallel with this.
And you made it mount to the original screw that was in the stock?
Yeah. I just drilled and tapped a hole here, and then I actually shaped this to fit the curvature that they already had in it for the gun, because I wanted it to not spin around in there.
Yeah, it looks pretty nice.
This is armored fuel line, or brake line, whatever you want to call it. I just cut it and then used it as a spacer for the bolt so that it had something to kind of pinch to. And that's just to get this off so the camera doesn't pick up any of this stuff down here in the shot.
And then up here you just got like a typical quarter inch
thumb screw
type thing.
I drilled a hole in that and put fishing line on it because when we're out filming, we run around a lot and we lose these like crazy.
That's true. And what we got up here?
This is a foregrip off of a different gun. And we ended up not even using this because it didn't fit. So this was just in a box and it is really comfortable. I ended up just using carriage bolts and ran them through there with nylon spacers. There's about three on each side. Mm-hmm. And that holds it really tight to this, which, you know, it doesn't have very much wiggle in it, which is really great. I thought it was going to be a little loose, but it's not.
Okay, you want to go ahead and just kind of stand up and shoulder it to yourself so we can sort of see how it works and everything. But as you can see, because, you know, especially for us, because we do quite a bit of shooting, it's kind of a natural thing for us to do that. And we've kind of taught ourselves to be steady with a gun over the years. So it kind of brings that into this, where we can hold the camera as steady as possible. And like you said, when we're at the drag strip or following some car that's really fast, we can kind of swing with it, just like you'd be swinging when you're shooting at a clay pigeon or something.
We got, this is way easier doing this and tracking something like that, like you're shooting clay pigeons or something, than it is to hold a camera like that and try to freehand.
Try to be stable.
That's not easy.
Right. And you kind of turn it towards that right there, and you can kind of give them an idea of what it looks like. There's your sort of first-person shooter view there. But as you can see, when you got it shouldered here, you're looking right at your LCD screen. And it's a pretty light device, with that being all aluminum and everything. So it seems pretty easy to hold. I mean, it's far lighter than a gun, obviously. So I think it'll work pretty well. We haven't really experimented with it yet too much, but we'll get it out and use it pretty soon. But one thing, we're pretty certain that we should probably tape off a large portion of this and paint it with some fluorescent orange, or maybe get some duct tape or something like that. But just something to make it look a lot less like a weapon, because I think using this alongside the road to film cars or something would be a bad idea for sure.
I got out of my car to come in here so we could shoot this video, and there's a bar down the street. There's a bunch of people out there. I got stared at like crazy just walking like to the door with it. So we need to do something about that.
All right, make it a little bit safer, that's for sure.
I don't want to get gunned down over it.
But, you know, Jordan's always out there kind of experimenting with different things, and he's made a few other camera devices that you've probably seen on our channel, like the rolling dolly and the slider and that kind of thing, and each one of those have worked really well, so I'm sure this one will too. But anyway, we just wanted to show you guys and see what you thought, and something just a little bit different from us anyway. Well, thanks for watching and commenting and everything, and we'll see you later. Bye.